Hey, everybody. Doing a video today. I'm doing it on one of the Ghost Adventures episodes, and it's the one, it's called Aftershocks, and it's from the Texas Horror Hotel. Wanted to go over it because I want to show the inconsistencies in this video and of these investigations in general, but I just wanted to point it out on this video. These investigators seem to believe that, you know, there are human spirits, earthbound spirits, and there are evil spirits, demons. But for some odd reason, they think that they can only go by what these demons tell them, or what they catch on an EVP, or what they say, as solid proof evidence of what they really are. So if a spirit comes on and says that they are, you know, a young boy named Frank that died years ago, you know, they believe it. They basically just say, that's it. You know, we found out it's a human spirit that lived here before, blah, blah, blah. There's like no questioning anything. But see, that's how these evil spirits, you know, get access to us, and how they, you know, are able to continue, you know, meddling in our lives and stuff, you know, because once you open yourself up into this, while you're in this stuff, you're opening yourself up, and, you know, a lot of things can happen. It will. It's not can, it will. Things will start happening in your life. They will start wreaking havoc in your life. So anyway, this video I wanted to show some pieces of it. I don't own rights to it. I'm merely only showing pieces of it in order to point out things for teaching purposes. So I'm going to go ahead and start now, and I will come back as soon as I come to a part I think I should mention something. He said that right. We don't know what they are. They could be demons. You see what I mean? But he doesn't know. He doesn't know. In any place he goes to, he does not know. He cannot prove it's not a demon. He doesn't understand it enough, bless his heart. You see, he's only focusing on the one bad spirit. He's not looking at William, Emma, and those. You see what I'm saying? How does she know? They only go by what they're being told. I want to do
history.
So here comes the ghost hunting guru. Sad to say, he's just as old as Zach is. He doesn't have a clue. You heard that, guys. He doesn't think it's an evil spirit. It's just a real pissed off spirit. Now, what I want to know is, where does he come to that conclusion? People's been getting attacked. It's by an unknown force and an invisible force, causing her to become obsessed, changes in her character, you name it. Okay, but he doesn't think it's an evil spirit. It's just a pissed off spirit. It's like, where does he get that from? I hate to tell you, but you're a sitting duck too. All of you guys are that sitting in these places, calling on these spirits, trying to summon these spirits, doing EVPs and all this stuff, you're truly being a sitting duck. You are going to attract spirits that you're not going to be able to escape from. Not without the hand of the Lord. Now, how does he come to this conclusion? How does he come to the conclusion that some of them's just good spirits? How does he come to that conclusion? By what they tell him. You can't believe everything a spirit tells you. You know, Satan is not just a liar. He's the father of lies. You know what I'm saying? You know, the Bible tells us that in the last days, you know, he's the one that deceived the whole world. That includes me. That includes you. That includes anybody watching this. At one time or another in our lives, we're going to be deceived. You know, so it's not, I'm not all that. I don't know all that. But I'll tell you one thing. I was deceived about the paranormal. And I will share the truth about the paranormal. As long as I have breath in my body and I'm able to do it, I am going to share the truth about what the paranormal really is and what these spirits truly are. And they are demonic spirits masquerading as your deceased loved ones because they want to have access to your life. And if you're talking to them, communicating with them, asking them for a sign, they have a legal right in your life and in your family's lives. Okay, so it's important. So he's telling her first that she should not go back. Now it's, well, if you do go back, just be careful. Just know what it might be. Now, how is she going to be careful? How is she going to be safe? It's not going to happen. As long as she's dabbling in this stuff, it's not, she's not going to be safe. You see, these other spirits are an attraction. They are the ones that are luring people in. They're the ones that the people are, you know, stay so focused on, and they think that they're helping. But, you know, that's just a, it's nothing more than a demon in disguise. You see, that's how I was. I thought the same thing. I thought that there were some spirits that would mimic and counterfeit and pretend to be that small child. But there were cases where it ended up proving to be different. You see what I'm saying? But they don't always prove to be different. They keep people deceived because they'll continue to pretend like there are still those innocent spirits in the place, you see. So people believe in this mimicking technique that the enemy uses, but they just refuse to believe that that's always the case. The reason why is because they don't want it to ruin their fun. I know, I've done it. I've been there. I've had my brothers telling me, you know, giving me Bible verses and stuff saying, look, when we die, we're no longer here. You're talking to demons. I didn't want to believe it because I was having too much fun. I was attracted to going into the paranormal and doing these ghost hunts and everything, and I did not want the truth. And that's the reason why most of these people don't want the truth, is because they enjoy doing it. It's an addiction. It's a fascination like no other. Now, he says that. Why is it so difficult for him to know that that's always the case? That's exactly what they do. You see, it's so frustrating because it's like, you see, that's what's going on. But they want to hold on to that belief, you know, that, well, you know, maybe our spirits really are still here when we die. I think it also has a lot to do with people doesn't want to know the truth about what really happens when we die. Because people that do go to heaven, hey, they're in heaven. But what about those that are not believers? They're no longer here. They are in hell. And people don't want to believe that. They want to stay pacified on a lie that, no, we're still here roaming the earth. Nothing happens. We're going to just stay around here. And, you know, I don't think so, guys. I'm sorry, but that's not the truth. And what I want to know is, what does it matter if you keep it in your mind, if you don't act on it, if you don't stop doing it? You know, they're sitting there saying it's a danger, that it's something that, yeah, they've seen that happen, but you just have to just know it. You know, what sense is that? That's like telling somebody, don't walk out in the middle of the road. Just kind of keep it in your mind. You can get hit by a car, but just don't look when the cars are coming. Just walk out in the road, but just keep it in mind that you could get hit. You know, doesn't make any sense at all. Yeah, so maybe once she gets a spiritual attack that's so bad that she becomes possessed, they'll call Zach, you know, but he doesn't even know the truth. So, you know, I don't mean to sound so negative, but it's really bad. You know, this paranormal shows is like a spiritual plague going across our land. You know, people really are getting into it so much. It's even in cartoons and stuff, you know, they got that new movie. Well, it's not so new, I come to find out. But it's called Paranorman. That's what it is. It's about a little boy. It claims that he has this gift of talking to the dead. You know, that's not a gift. You know, if you're seeing spirits, you have some, you got a door wide open to the demonic, and it's causing them to be able to have access to you. So anyway, God bless you guys, and I will talk to you again soon. Bye-bye.